From the JAMA Network, this is JAMA Clinical Reviews, interviews and ideas about innovations in medicine, science, and clinical practice.
Hello, and welcome to this JAMA Clinical Reviews podcast. I'm Dr. Kirsten Bibbins-Domingo, and I'm the editor-in-chief of JAMA and the JAMA Network. I'm joined today by Dr. Wanda Nicholson. Dr. Nicholson is an obstetrician-gynecologist and professor of preventive and community health at the Milken Institute School of Public Health at George Washington University, where she is also the Senior Associate Dean for Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion. Dr. Nicholson is a member and vice president of the Board of Directors at the American Board of Obstetrics and Gynecology and a past member of the Executive Board of ACOG. But today, we are speaking to her in her capacity as chair of the U.S. Preventive Services Task Force. JAMA has published an updated recommendation statement from the U.S. Preventive Services Task Force on screening for breast cancer. JAMA has also published the evidence report on which the recommendation statement is based. Dr. Nicholson, thank you for joining me here today.
Well, Kirsten, thank you so much for having me to discuss the task force's recommendation on breast cancer screening.
Wonderful. So I usually like to begin these with just asking you to give us a high-level summary of this recommendation statement. What is the task force recommending?
Certainly. Well, Kirsten, we know that screening for breast cancer saves lives. And now the science shows us that all women should begin screening at age 40 and continue every other year until age 74. This new science, or the latest science, makes it clear that this new recommendation could save even more lives, up to potentially 20% more lives from breast cancer. So very pleased to bring this recommendation forward.
Okay, so let's dig a little bit deeper. This is a change, specifically a change in the recommendation for those women in their 40s. In the past, the task force noted the benefits of screening for women in their 40s, that the net benefit was small for beginning earlier for these women, and that women should make their own decisions with their doctors. Why did the task force make a change to the stronger B recommendation for women in their 40s?
Well, previously, you are correct that we recommended for women ages 40 to 49 that they would make a decision about where in the age range of 40 to 49 to begin screening and how often, based on their preferences and values, and of course, in collaboration with their trusted clinician. But again, we have new updated evidence from actually three sources that have pointed us in a different direction. First, we've been able to look at incidence rates of breast cancer in women ages 40 to 49, and we're noticing a rising incidence in that. In fact, about a 2% increase every year since 2015. Secondly, as part of our evidence review at this time, we were also able to obtain updated information from the Breast Cancer Surveillance Consortium. This is a national database that is supported by the National Cancer Institute. So we were able to take data from this updated data set and input it into our collaborative modeling studies. And looking across holistically at those three areas of resources of data, the incidence rates, the Breast Cancer Surveillance Consortium data, and updated collaborative models, it showed clearly that when you look at the balance of benefits and harms, and the benefits in this case outweigh the harms at our letter grade B recommendation, that all women should start at age 40 and continue mammography screening every other year until age 74.
Okay, that's very helpful to understand the new evidence. It makes sense that an earlier detection with mammography screening would result in net benefit, in this case, decrease in mortality from breast cancer. Talk a little bit about the harms that the task force did consider and, in fact, thought about quite a bit, especially for women in their 40s.
Well, thank you for that question, Kirsten, because as you know, in all of our recommendations, wherever we're reviewing the evidence, the task force is always focused on the balance of benefits and harms. We want to recommend preventive services that are going to move health forward for individuals to live healthier and longer lives. That's the obvious benefit. But we know that we also have to look at the other side of that equation, which is the harms. So in this case, we looked at potential harms such as false positives. So perhaps if you had a screening mammography, it had a positive result that ultimately turned out to be a false positive, which could potentially lead to additional biopsies that may in the end be deemed unnecessary, and in some cases expose individuals to treatments that might be otherwise unnecessary and may have associated side effects. when we looked at our totality of the data, what we found is that the benefits of screening starting at age 40 every other year to age 74 clearly outweighed the potential harms. And so this is the strategy that we're putting forward in this new recommendation.
Great. So the interval for screening is every other year. Some have called for more frequent screenings. And in fact, this is discussed in the recommendation statement, especially for women in that younger age group. How did the task force arrive at every other year screening as the optimal for the benefits and harms?
Well, again, Ms. Kirsten, that was looking across the totality of the evidence that we had. At this particular time point, we actually did not have any randomized clinical trials randomizing any population of women to annual screening versus every other year. So we're missing that important element of evidence that could inform our recommendation. However, given this situation, we looked very closely at our collaborative modeling studies and was able to look, for example, at age to start screening, age to stop screening, and the interval of screening in our collaborative modeling that was updated this year. And when we looked at those modeling studies across age groups and looked again at the balance of benefits and harms, we arrived at every other year rather than annually. And the reason again for that is that when you look at those results of our studies and look at the evidence in totality, women gain the benefit from being screened every other year with fewer harms. So if you compare that to annual screening, where the harms were much higher. And specifically, in fact, if you looked at annual screening, there was a 50% higher false positive rate of mammography compared to every other year. So again, our goal is to balance those benefits and harms, and annual screening actually placed individuals at a greater harm with those false positive results.
I want to talk about one other part of this recommendation statement that has an eye, and this is for women with dense breasts. Now, women with dense breasts are at increased risk for breast cancer. Mammography is not as well suited to finding this breast cancer. But the task force, again, says that there is not sufficient evidence to make a recommendation for or against additional types of screening modalities. Can you talk about that a little bit?
You're right. This is such an important topic. We know that over 40% of women in the U.S. have dense breasts. And I think that we as clinicians and across the task force as clinicians have encountered our patients who have come to us with the mammography result. And although their mammography screening may have been negative, they were still given the category that they had dense breasts. So this is an incredibly important topic. When we looked as part of our current evidence review, we did not see any clinical trials comparing what we call supplemental screening. So in other words, we had the question, in women with dense breasts, is there a stronger screening strategy if we have mammography plus MRI or mammography plus ultrasound compared to mammography alone? And we don't currently have sufficient evidence addressing that question. So two next steps. First of all, of course, we're calling for additional research in this area and calling for it urgently. Meantime, what patients should do is to have that one-to-one conversation with their trusted provider, taking into account their history, their values, and their preferences as to whether getting additional screening, supplemental screening, is the right step for them.
Great. Now, I know the task force works on its own and is independent, but this is an area where there are other professional societies making recommendations. How does the task force recommendation compare to the statements of other organizations?
Well, you are correct that there can be some variations in current recommendations. In particular, you'll certainly see consistency across all women presenting for mammography beginning at age 50 up to age 74. You'll see that consistently across different organizations. There can be some variations in where in that 40 to 49 age range to start. But again, I believe if you compare the task force recommendations to others, there's more similarities than differences. Our interpretation of the current evidence is to start at age 40 and continue every other year until age 74.
Wonderful. And an important piece to note here, because the task force, of course, has made recommendations on this topic before, is that the task force is updating recommendations based on new evidence, as it seems to have been the case here.
You are correct. And we consistently update our recommendation statements at different intervals. But even within those intervals, if there's new data, new trials that come to bear, we will certainly update our recommendations at that time. We are consistently and constantly looking for research. We want these questions answered. So when you see these I statements that you indicated, particularly for women with dense breasts, we want to see new data come forward to help us be able to move forward with an actual letter grade recommendation if possible.
So I imagine that for women who are following these recommendations, for clinicians who are seeking to implement them, they want to cut to the chase, to the bottom line. So give us the bottom line for the patients. What do you want patients to know and what do you want clinicians to know?
Well, several important messages. First of all, again, to iterate that the current science now shows that all women should begin screening at age 40 and continue every other year until age 74. We also know that Black women are 40% more likely to die from breast cancer compared to their white counterparts. So this recommendation is particularly important for Black women. As I mentioned earlier, with this new recommendation, we can save potentially up to 20% more lives and actually a slightly even higher amount among Black women. Also to emphasize that screening is such an important, obvious first step, but we know that the downstream steps of follow-up, appropriate biopsies if indicated, and access to equitable treatments are also crucial for all women, but particularly Black women, to really receive this benefit of this letter grade B recommendation. And then finally to say that we do have areas that need additional research, such as the best screening strategy in individuals with dense breasts. So again, looking and urgently calling for more research in that particular area. But the primary take-home message is mammography saves lives, and new science shows that we can increase the lives saved by about 20% by starting at age 40 and continuing every other year until age 74.
Wonderful. There's one point that you made that I want to give us a chance to highlight again. You are not making separate recommendations for Black women, but you are noting that there is a higher mortality rate for Black women. And so the impact of this recommendation that applies to all women who are undergoing screening could have particular benefit in that group. Is that correct?
That's correct. And thanks for that segue, Kirsten. As part of the new evidence that we were able to review this year is that we were able to commission modeling studies overall for all women. But in addition, we had modeling studies commissioned specifically for Black women. So we specifically looked at the question that for Black women, given that much higher death rate from breast cancer, whether Black women should undergo a different screening strategy. So we looked at whether or not, for example, should Black women be screened annually versus every other year. We looked at that in our collaborative modeling studies. And believe me, our goal was to really look intently at this data, which we did. And when we looked at that data, we found again that there may be a slight increase in benefit with annual screening for Black women, but that slight increase in benefit was far outweighed by the harms, particularly a 50% higher false positive rate and all of the subsequent potential adverse downstream consequences of that. So at this point, based on our current evidence review, we recommend that all women proceed with starting at age 40 and screen at every other year intervals until age 74.
Great. Such an important point. So it sounds like this is a recommendation for all women. Black women in particular should take note of this recommendation and the clinicians who care for them. And I guess I would underscore, too, that you actually looked at the data for that group in particular. And so another way in which the evidence is being used to make the types of decisions here. So this is really terrific. Thank you for taking the time to share this statement and the task force's rationale for this statement. Is there anything else you want to add?
First, let me thank you and JAMA again for this opportunity to talk about our breast cancer recommendation statement. Again, the fact that mammography saves lives, and again, the task force continues to be committed to recommending preventive services that we know will help individuals to live healthier and longer lives.
Okay, thank you so much. I've been speaking with Dr. Wanda Nicholson, an obstetrician gynecologist and the chair of the U.S. Preventive Services Task Force. We've been talking about the updated recommendation statement on screening for breast cancer. This episode was produced by Daniel Morrow at the JAMA Network. To follow this and other JAMA Network podcasts, please visit us online at jamanetworkaudio.com. Thanks for listening.